10 best examples of boosting profits with condition marketing. By Barry Dunlop. Topics: make money online. More posts about conversion, optimization, website monetization. Today I want to introduce you to two new marketing strategies that most of you probably haven't heard of, but could well have the capability to revolutionize the way you do business online. These two new strategies are condition marketing, show marketing. Depending on the way a user interacts with your website, and sequence marketing, showing marketing. Depending on where a user is in your sales funnel. As far as I can see it, all advertising is wasteful advertising if you are not targeting the people who want to see your adverts by using condition and sequence marketing. Below are my top tips for drastically increasing your conversion rates. Make sure to read until the end to find out about our brand new tool that will systemize this whole process for you and allow you to do it at a mere fraction of the time and cost. 10 best ways to reduce wasteful advertising. 1. Replace email sign-up boxes after a visitor subscribes. This is probably the most common mistake I see websites make, and it's not just done by amateurs, it's a flaw in usability that can be seen on the most successful of websites. If a website visitor has subscribed for your email list, why do they need to keep seeing your opt-in boxes for a list they have already subscribed to? Here on Income Diary, once you subscribe for our email list, we replace our opt-in boxes with advertising for the next step in our marketing sequence. Every time they do as we suggest, they move along in the sequence and see different adverts depending on where they are in our sales funnel. 2. Replace product adverts for the people who have already bought the product. Similar to your email subscribe boxes, what's the point of showing adverts for a product a visitor has already purchased? If someone buys from you, they have qualified themselves as a higher quality lead to sell to, and by wasting advertising space, you are wasting opportunities to make money. Make sure to replace adverts for those that have bought your products with something new and appealing. 3. Bundle discounts for visitors who look at multiple sales pages. If someone looks at several of your product sales pages, why not replace and review sites like Yelp can drive referral traffic to your website with minimal work from you. Managing your reputation makes you visible on a website that already appears high in search engines. Know what people are saying about you. Put strategies in place to get more reviews. Never buy reviews or ask for great reviews. But when asked nicely, most people would give you at least a 4-star review. Your adverts with a discount if they buy several products at the same time. 4. Offer incentives to visitors who look at your sales page several times and don't buy. If someone goes to pop-up domination and they don't buy after the first 2 visits, the next time they visit the sales page, they will be presented with a 30-day free trial available only if they sign up in the next 48 hours. If they still don't buy, it goes back to the normal sales page for their next visit. Then we replace the sales page again after that to offer a 60-day free trial. with a 24-hour countdown to sign up. Incentives and scarcity are some of the strongest ways to boost sales. Including it in your conditional marketing will only further boost your conversion rate. 5. Stop showing adverts to those who have shown no interest in the subject. This is another big problem I see happening on a lot of large websites, particularly retail websites. Why are you showing advertising for a product about a subject I have not shown interest in? We find that we are better off showing adverts related to the category a user is currently viewing on our websites and customize the user experience accordingly. 6. Stop showing the same advert 20 times to someone and expecting them to suddenly be interested on the 21st time. If someone sees your advert over and over again and they don't even click it, it's likely that they don't have any interest in it. Why not replace unclicked product adverts with different products? There is no reason you can't display the old advert again later in your sequence. This way, you are simply increasing your chances of making a sale. 7. Stop showing the wrong currency. If you are able to accept multiple currencies, why not show pricing in the currency of the country of your visitor? Visitors are more likely to trust a local company than a company that they have no idea where it is. Perhaps you are not local, but by offering pricing in their local currency, not only will the user experience be improved, but it's likely a user would trust you more. 8. Showing adverts for products that can only be bought by people in your country to people outside of your country. If your product only ships to certain countries, why show your adverts to everyone? You will see with the next tip that advertising doesn't always have to be about getting sales, but it can also be used indirectly to boost traffic and sales as well. 9. Trying to sell to someone who will never buy from you. This is a big problem, and because it's a big problem, there is a huge opportunity for gain. A huge percent of people who visit your website have no intention and will never buy from you. So what do you do with visits such as this? You get them to help you with marketing. Share boxes and buttons to help increase traffic. They may not want to buy something from you, but their friends might. 10. Let users skip to the next advert. The whole idea of marketing is to get someone to notice you, interact with you, and ultimately buy from you. Using a skip button means you can give the user the power. Not only that, but it also at a subconscious level trains them to click your ads. Here's how I'm going to test it for promoting Why Compete. Advert 1, sign up for Why Compete's sequence marketing tool and create cool adverts like this. Under the sign up button will be a link saying, no thanks, not interested. When they click this link, the next ad appears. Advert 2, you are not interested in seeing conversions 3x higher than you are currently seeing? What if I told you that you could have a 30-day free trial? Would you be interested then? They may think to themselves, I have never seen something like this before, maybe I should sign up. Perhaps that's a little optimistic, only time will tell. In reality, it doesn't have to stop there, though. You can show another advert after this, saying something like, okay, I understand, you are not interested right now. In the meantime, why not read this blog post about our tool. 10 Best Examples of Boosting Profits with Condition Marketing. Yes, that's right, we could use this very post a link to in the advert, then. They can read about the thought process behind this feature. How to do all this with the brand new, first of its kind, condition and sequence marketing tool, by Why Compete. The reason why condition and sequence marketing is more or less unheard of until now, is because it's not been possible to implement without a significant investment in development. Over the years, my team and I have created custom advertising experiences with great success. Very occasionally, I have also seen top marketers try to do some basic sequence marketing as well. But until today, it has never been easy. Hard work is what stops the vast majority of business owners from accomplishing conversion rates far higher than they currently are getting. That all changes right now with Why Compete's sequence marketing tool. You can now create and customize advertising experiences for the people that visit your website in minutes. Research and planning. This involves doing a competitive analysis as well as researching to develop strategies you'll use. What do they say? Fail to plan. Plan to fail. This is no truer than it is in digital marketing management. Someone will need to set up and manage the strategies you put in place. Make data-driven changes if things aren't working. Do more of what is. Nothing in marketing is a set it and forget it proposition. Content creation and curation. You'll need funds set aside to pay a person to create original content and collect other content that helps you meet goals. This may be ad copy, landing pages, apps, blogs, videos, memes, etc. Analytics tools. You'll need analytical tools to track strategy effectiveness. Some are free like Google Analytics, but it's worth exploring paid tools. They go much deeper than you can manually, and they make it easier to understand what your data means and how to use it. Management and automation tools. When you start trying to figure out how to get traffic to your website, you may be amazed. There are millions of moving pieces to manage. Timing is everything. The work is often time-consuming and monotonous without the right tools. SEO timeframes. It's important to realize that SEO is not an instant traffic generator. Steer clear of people who make promises that seem too good to be true. Instead, SEO builds slowly and compounds, increasing traffic over time, and it helps you provide a better experience to visitors that enter from other sources. Google says it takes about a year for an optimized site to move up in the ranks to generate significant traffic. When working with SEO experts who have a Google Align system in place, you can usually see incredible growth by 6-9 months. Maintain it to see it continue to go up. That's how to get traffic to your website on a budget. Once you have your website optimized, apply other cost-effective strategies to drive initial traffic. Show Google you deserve high visibility in searches. Next, let's look at how social media contributes when you need to figure out how to get traffic to your website. Building a brand on social media. Building a social media brand is similar across social media sites. But there are different strategies to increase visibility on these sites. We'll look at some of the across-the-board ways to build up your profile. Fill your profile out entirely. If the site offers a business profile, use it if you're a business. Share high-quality custom content. At least 50% of this content should be created by your company. This may include any of the following that you created: videos, links to your blog, infographics, GIFs, memes, inspirational images, messages, etc. Share no more than 50% quality curated content. This content is strategically gathered. It may include your own headlines, or you may just hit the share button. Use content generated by influencers in your industry. Also, use content created by your customers and fans. Collect and use relevant hashtags, e.g., #ItlHawks. Think of hashtags like a file folder on your computer. When you use one, you're putting something in that folder on the social media site. When someone is looking for something in the category, they use that hashtag to see what people have put in that folder. Respond to comments and messages. These are often people who want to learn more about your brand. Don't miss the opportunity. If the comment is negative, choose a level-headed response that best reflects your brand and the situation. Encourage existing customers to follow you on your social media of choice. Make it easy for people to share your content. Provide social media icons on blog pages, emails, videos, etc. Don't directly promote on social media. If you have a good following and some loyalty, occasional offers are okay. But pay attention to how people respond. They don't typically appreciate open marketing on social media unless you've purchased ad space. Run contests to get more followers, leads, and traffic. Tailor it to your customers. Invest in local SEO. If you're a local business, search engines like Google don't think you should have to compete with huge companies in your local area. They show preferential treatment to local businesses. But in order to get this treatment, they need to know you're local. Your website may be hosted in California or New Jersey, but your business is in Georgia or Tennessee. Or you may serve several counties. You may serve a very small area exclusively. People may ask for this neighborhood by name. It's hard for Google to make that call. They rely on you to communicate behind the scenes regarding what your local area really is. How to show Google you're local. Here are some steps you and your webmaster can take today to demonstrate that you're local. Some of it happens on your site. On-page SEO. Other steps require off-page SEO. That's doing things off your website that help SEO your website.
Follow us. Google Search. www.googlesearch.co.in. Facebook/blog2page/. www.facebook.com/weblink. Twitter.com/blog2bebd. Twitter.com/weblink. If you like this video, click like icon and share your friends.
If you want more best videos, please subscribe and click bell icon.